The excitement is starting to build here at the Hungaro Ring as the lights are about to go green for today's qualifying session. We expect some cars out on track any moment now.
Thank you.
as we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Ricardo, Hamilton, and Max Verstappen. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Right, I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Your attitude during interactions with the media has a bearing on how you're considered by each team. Some value showmanship, others sportsmanship. Matching your behaviour to the team's expectations will give us a stronger position during contract negotiations.
It's always wonderful to come back to the lively Hungaroring, a popular destination this, nice and close to the beautiful city of Budapest, with some exciting racing to boot. Who can forget Michael Schumacher pushing his old teammate Rubens Barrichello up towards the pit wall in 2010, or those great races of 2014 and 2015 as well. Located 12 miles northeast of the Hungarian capital Budapest, the 14 corners of the Hungaroring are steeped in history and prestige. Overtaking has always been difficult on this technical 2.7-mile circuit, but the last few years in particular have turned up some exceptional races. Let's hope we're in for another one here today. Also here, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk briefly about Sebastian Vettel. Looks like they've got a tough race in store today, as grid penalties from changing power unit components has forced them further down the field.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, and Ocon, Hülkenberg, Perez, the Rainmaster, and Kevin Magnussen, Gasly, Van Dorn, Romain Grosjean, and Leclerc, Raikkonen, Sainz, Brendan Hartley, and Marcus Ericsson. Stroll, and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, you've qualified higher than we expected, so let's try to build on this position throughout the race.
Thank you.
They've just entered the pits. They're on old ultra softs. Their tyres are 11 laps old. We think they've got at least three more stops. The time last lap was a 1:28.8. Lance is in the pits. Bottas is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 19.4 seconds. They're on fresh softs. We think they've got one more stop. Thank you. gap to the car behind is 8.4 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Their tyres are 8 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 27.8. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed? Ahead, our gap to the car in front is 20.6 seconds. You're losing 3 seconds a lap. They're on fresh softs. Their tyres are 8 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:26.8. least 20 minutes of light rain. Dries seem like the best tyre for now. This rain could be with us for a while. Light rain conditions for the foreseeable future. Dries seem like the fastest tyre at the moment.
Is in for him.
pit stop. Is in the pits. strategy is available on the MFT. Confirmed. with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay. Dries seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Behind. The gap behind us is 11.7 seconds. They're on fresh ultrasofts. Their tyres are 6 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 28.6. Hamilton ahead. The gap to the car ahead is 50.9 seconds. We're 2.5 seconds slower. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 20 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:30.0. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. We'll be seeing at least 20 minutes of light rain. Dries seem like the best tyre for now. The tyre situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now. Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap. Hungary seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Seem like the best tyre for now. Currently P11, we're currently P11. Grosjean is ahead of you. Less than a second separate you. They're on fresh softs. Hülkenberg behind. The gap is less than a second. They're on old softs. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. 36 laps to go. It should be a few laps at least before you start feeling too many tyre issues. They seem in good condition for the time being. Dry seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Some information on Ericsson. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Seem like the best tyre for now. clear patch on its way. There's about 10 more minutes of this rain. Dry seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD.
So, another fantastic victory for Red Bull today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Taking care of the car was absolutely vital today. It's been obvious all weekend that the pace was there, but look at the attrition rate we've had. They would have been very concerned about any minor anomaly towards the latter stages of this Grand Prix.
And I can see now, the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Red Bull move to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Toro Rosso's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time, though, goodbye.
Well, things didn't really go your way today. Tell us what happened.
It must be devastating to not make it to the end of a race like this. It looks like your arrival is schooling you a bit. There was quite a lot of contact today, wasn't there?
Great. Well, that's everything.
You okay? Nothing more than bumps and bruises, I hope. I wish I could say the same for the car. That thing is quite a mess. What a disappointing end to a lot of hard work this weekend. Still, we've got plenty of repair time before the next race. It'll be just like new in time for the next Grand Prix.
Here we can adjust the terms of our proposal. The more ambitiously we set our targets, the more willing the team will be to give us better perks. We'll have a few chances to suggest a deal, but we need to be careful. If a proposed contract exceeds your value to the team,